Welcome back, coders, to another video. This is going to be a special quick dive into Minecraft for the Nintendo Switch. The reason for this tonight is actually because we have some news straight out of 4J Studios that the Minecraft version for Nintendo Switch, was recently updated. We're going to kind of find out a little bit about what that entails. The main thing that you'll notice today, we're going to continue playing offline, we're going to create a new one, is actually just the inclusion of, we're going to do creative, and then make sure we do all this, is the inclusion of the bump in resolution when docked to 1080p. That'll be really quickly apparent when you jump into the game. It's no longer 720p, and it really does improve things. Everything looks good there. Yep, we're doing a trial test. That's fine. We're not going to save or anything like that. But really, the vast improvement comes at almost no expense. In many cases, from what I've seen, a slight boost to the frame rate. So, as you can see as this loads up, the boost in resolution is just an absolute delight. It comes with much less aliasing. It allows us to really see and showcase just the improvements there. The big thing here, though, is that overall the game looks really, really good. Now, unfortunately, I'm recording this in 30 frames per second, which I will fix for any subsequent videos that we do. But this is also running at 60 FPS, and the big thing that I noticed was that many of the moments of stutter that we used to see with regards to just like an overload to the GPU or CPU for the Nintendo Switch are gone. And now we're seeing a really, really, really smooth game. It was 99% smooth, 98% smooth in the original version, don't get me wrong, and it was running at 720p. But obviously they've put in some serious work. Wow, I have not gotten a chance to see the Fallout world in this game yet, and it looks better than ever. The other thing they were able to keep is the draw distance. They didn't have to change anything to the draw distance. It still renders out 11 to 12 chunks, which was found out by Digital Foundry, great guys over there. I use them a ton, by the way. They're an awesome resource for this kind of technical in-depth information. Specifically, they mentioned that there's actually been an improvement in the anisotropic filtering, which is actually really cool because now you don't get those oblique angles on textures looking muddy and ugly. And it is noticeable. It's a subtle thing, but it's noticeable. As you can see, this looks really, really good. And there's kind of just a wow factor when you first fire it up. The other things that they've added, again, were some texture packs and some other things that you can then customize in the game that you couldn't before. I heard rumor that the touchscreen is now usable there. I haven't got a chance to verify that myself. But if I find out that that's true, I'll definitely update you guys on that and let you know. So this looks like this is Fallout 4 texture pack, because that is the Boston baseball stadium, and then this is the giant tower in Fallout 4. I remember a lot of this stuff because I loved that game. Anyway, we're not going to jump off and die, but I forgot how to, that's what it was, double jump, okay. So we're going to fly through this, and you can see like how quickly it's able to load all this stuff. And there is some stutter, there's some minor stutter, but it's like, it's really minimal, even when we're flying at very high speeds through this world, and doing some pretty intensive stuff here. Wow, they did a great job recreating this. Well, this is impressive. Even all the areas are like remade. And this is the entrance. Okay, we can fly through. Whoa, look at all this. This is so cool. Wow, they did an amazing ass job. Well, I'm glad we got a chance to check this out too. And here's the tower. Let's go up to the top and see what's up here. Not much, but man, it gives you a really good view of what you of this Fallout 4 world. They really fleshed this out. This is probably an exact recreation of the map. I got to give them major props here. I wonder if the Institute is featured in this game. If you can go underground and see the Institute. There does seem to be something down here, so let's check this out. Okay, I don't see much down there. This might just be like the, some sort of, I don't even know, pyramid, which is pretty cool. But yeah, I'm having a lot of fun just kind of investigating this as well. Okay, so there is the classic trailer from the, was that Fallout 3? Fallout 3 reference, right? I'll listen to the music too. I forgot how to. Oh yeah, right stick in. That's how you go down. Sorry, I'm just trying to remember the controls. So this is from the original trailer for Fallout 3, which was one of those trailers that like shocked the universe. It's so great. Let's see if the Institute, if we can find any evidence of the Institute in here. I don't seem to see anything. I think it was underneath one of these buildings. Let's check this out. I'm gonna see if we can find that. For all you Fallout 4 fans, I definitely recommend checking this out, even if you just want to check out the pack itself and not like get too involved, because this is a really good rendition of the Fallout world for sure. Very impressed by it. Is this the? What is this place? I don't remember everything. Oh, so that's the. Okay, never mind. And here's the main town in the first game, or in the fourth game, I think. Very cool, very cool. So as you can see, a lot of really cool things that they were able to pull off. And here's the airship as well. And I never explored this in Fallout 4. Hey, if you guys explored this in Fallout 4, please let me know a little bit more about like what that entails in terms of the side quest. I'd love to go back, but I haven't had a chance to, so someday maybe in the future I'll be able to do that. But as of right now, I'm going to rely on you guys to kind of give me some information there. Oh, here's the subway. Oh, ooh, maybe we can go down. Okay, let's keep on going down. Down, 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 down. And I know. Nobody else. Down, 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 da, 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 da. Okay, we're just gonna walk because it's easier down here. Okay, so here's the train station. I love the music that they managed to put in the game too. See, this is fun, exploring these little packs and kind of seeing what they have to hold. So there's a whole train system in here. They did a really good job. Detector rail, very nice. Oh, there's a spider. Oh, there's a jelly. Get away from me, jelly. Probably shouldn't have gone down here, but who cares? We're down here and we're exploring. We're not going to be going too much longer. I just wanted to make sure you guys got a chance to see everything. So hopefully you guys enjoy this little tour through Fallout 4's texture pack and the new update from 4J Studios on Minecraft. This is really cool to be able to explore this world in such detail. So we're going to get out of here. How? I'm not sure. Ah, right there. What is this? So these are a block of emerald. Nice. Okay. Interesting. Let's go upstairs. And keep rising. Now let's get back up high. That way we can see what we're exploring. There's the stadium again. And we're checking this out. Really cool stuff. It'd be cool if there were super mutants, but there doesn't seem to be. Okay, so this is the town from Fallout 3. I can't remember. Nuketown, I think is what it's called. Yeah, Nuketown. Pretty positive. I didn't play a ton of Fallout 3. I played a ton of Fallout 4, but I did not play a ton of Fallout 3. So, excuse me for any sort of references that I'm not noticing here. Whoa, cool. We got this little desert area. The church. Very cool. Very cool. I'm digging it. What is this thing? Oh, that's another subway station. So, it's all connected. This is an impressive build. I gotta say, I'm very blown away by this. will feed my hungry heart. Looks like there's a little airship that they've designed over here that's crash landed, maybe like a helicopter. And I don't know what this is. Probably something that I'm not familiar with. We're just gonna fly through. See if we can see anything cool. When I'm alone. Wow, you can get lost in here. This is a real dangerous game right here. Probably not good to get lost in here. See if we can get out. Whoa. I don't know where I'm at. This is not good. Oh, give me your lips for just a moment. At least we have some really beautiful music to calm us down so that I don't freak out right now. Because I'm going to freak out. I'm going to freak out. What you alone can give. A kiss to build a dream on. And we're out. Look at that, I escaped. I'm super clever. I ruined their world, but I escaped. So this looks like that little perfect town, maybe? No, that's not right. That's not from Fallout 4. There is that perfect town. I wonder if they have that here. Well, this place is impressive. God, they really did a number in this world. I wonder how big this map is. It seems quite large. Of course, we can't see it all at once, so it makes it difficult to kind of get an idea of whether or not it is as big as we think it is. A lot of foresty areas. That portal. Oh, that's to the Nether. We're gonna get the heck out. Let me out. Thank you. I didn't want to go to the Nether. And with that, we're going to fly up real high and kind of sign this off. Just so you guys can get one last beautiful view of this nice world. And please make sure to leave a like on this video. It does help the channel out a lot, but even more if you are new to the channel and you like what you've seen so far, definitely subscribe to the channel. Make sure you hit that notification bubble, because that will help you guys get any sort of notifications for future streams, videos, anything that we plan on doing, and we do plan on doing a lot. So we really appreciate your guys' continued support, and for those of you who are coming back, again, much love to you guys, and we hope to see you soon. So for all of us over here at Game Code, just want to thank you for that support as well, and as always, stay classy, coders.